Hello, everyone. I think I'm back here now for our second game of the afternoon, as we have the Fira Sharks, led by Nala Nipiko, batting first. They really need to step up here and get a decent score on the board. As you see last week, the Melee Taffia Bulls chased down 130 last week, so they're going to be able to do that again. So the Sharks are really, really under the pump here. They've got to pull something out of the fire here and set up a good total in the first innings as they get a chance to bat again. They get a chance to redeem themselves. I've lost my co-commentator, Damien Smith. I think he's still crying over that last performance from the Sharks. Oh, he's running over now here, but he has got a sniffle, and there's a few tears still rolling down those cheeks. I think he's been trying to sneak in and play the second match for the Sharks. He's been over in there, going, come on, coach, give me a go. But, Damo, they didn't give you a go.
They didn't give me a go, and we won't be that bad twice, guys. We are back.
Okay.
We'll go through the Fira Sharks lineup for the second game.
Off you go, mate.
Nala Nipiko, captain, blasted 20 off the first over. Let's hope he gets off to a great start again. Jamal Vira, wicketkeeper. Mbong Rakau, Apolline Stephen, Bethan Molly, Nico Unavalu, Obed Yusuf, Stefan Sandy, Vince Vira, Bolton Kalrai.
One change, Mbong Rakau is in for Fernando.
Fernando
twice has given him a chance and he hasn't looked like it. So I would say that's the only change to the team from what I can see there. And the Melee Taffia Bulls, mate, you got that list there? Somewhere?
Yes, we do.
Oh, no, it'll be captained by Andrew Mansali because he just had a coin toss. Did you see that, Damo? He didn't call. Nolan's tossed a coin and Andrew watched it.
I tell you now, Andrew Mansali would be the worst captain for winning tosses. I once went on a tour with him. We lost 6 tosses in a row. He could not win a thing.
Well, you can't win the toss if you don't call. I've never seen anything like it.
Technically, he didn't win first.
And then the called heads, and no one knew if it was head or tail.
Yeah.
It was a shambles.
We'll have the Fira Sharks batting first, but the Melee Taffia Bulls line up is Andrew Mansali as captain, Clement Tommy, and man of the match last week as wicketkeeper. We have Damien Chilliard, Darren Watu, Jeffrey Mangay, Nono Chilia, Patrick Mataltava, Philip, we have...
Good luck saying that.
Yeah.
I just call him Philip, mate.
Raval Simpson, and Vincent Mataltava is our 12th man, and we have got coming back in William Singh Nalesa.
Whoa, William Singh Nalesa is back. He's number one spinner in Vanuatu at the moment, wrist spinner, young fella, all the tricks, leggies, wrongens. Yes. Yeah, he's always got a couple of groins, tweaks his groin regularly, but I think that's better now.
And we've got a change in the bowling lineup here from previous games. Patrick Mataltava will take the new ball against Narling Nipiko, who will take strike. And do we have William Yamak at the non-strikers end there?
I'm trying to work out who that is. Can't see his number. He's just on to us.
Like this matchup, it's the old bull, the young bull, Patrick Mataltava, favoured Lagoon End, pushing into the Bet Barter Bellevue Hill End.
I think it's Apo Stephen open the batting.
Okay, interesting move.
Yeah, I think it's Apo. We'll get something out of him because he was a shambles down the order last year. But this is big. Pat will push mid 130s when he gets it right. Slippers in too, and you bowl beautiful outswing shape as the first ball's gone in. He's run at the third man. Andrew's picked it up. It's a shy of stumps. Would have been. Now it's a super bit of fielding.
And that's why he has been voted twice player of the tournament in Australian Country Championships in Australia on many, many occasions.
Yeah, I'm not sure. We didn't get the right camera angle there. Hopefully we will for the second ball. But that was a great bit of fielding from slip. He's got to backward points and one hand throw at the stumps and nearly a run out. That's a nice shape. That's not out. It's off the pad.
They're cheering here. That's definitely off the pad there.
It was a great bit of keeping, but it was off the pad.
But Nigel Morrison at Lagoon End.
It's great shape.
Yeah, it was great shape.
He's got, keepers on. That's mid 130s there. mid-130s, and we don't get to see that replay. That was a fantastic bit of glove. He's an acrobatic keeper. And
Tommy out of the Peter Duffy stable down in Classic Bat Country, Melbourne. Matt Altar in now.
Oh, he's gone to war.
Why is he coming down the pitch like that? Did we not learn in the first game, Apo?
No. Apo would not have learned in the years he's played cricket. He would struggling to learn from his mistakes, to say the least. So he's played him the first one. He's gone wild swing the second. What's he going to do the third? It's a good short ball. He's backed away, and he's ballooned it to the 30-yard circle back there to third man. That's a good start for Pat. He's got a spring in his step today. I reckon he's up for the challenge. He's probably been probably our most well-known player in the last few years around the world. He made that unbelievable 100 in a T20 match in Malaysia last year. 100, I think it was the 14th fastest 100 in T20 I history. As he come, flicked off his toes. They'll go for one. Nipico's quick. They'll go for two. And they're back. That's a good start from Nalin. Having a look at him. Yeah, well, I'll take over the commentary while we sort that out as Patrick Motsitaba coming in, fourth ball over to Nala Nipico. Short boys, him in the helmet. It's gone to the keeper. Was the fifth ball over. The TV must be one behind, and that's over. It's a good over. That's a good bumper. That was obviously on the money. That was a great bumper right between the eyes. He was nowhere near that. As I said, he's good on the short ball, but he's can be a little bit slow early on the short ball. And we got William Signalis is coming into bowl from the Bet Barter Bellevue Hill end. And this is what we want to see. A wrist spinner, potential superstar of the game. I hope teams around the world will be watching. Franchise around the world. Got a bit of bat on off start. That's a great start. Fizzing it into the top of off stump there. Apo Stevens backed away and just got it out there for a single. Risky shot. But it's a great start for William Singh now, Lisa.
Yeah, I really like this from William Singh. And actually, he just wants to be in the game, doesn't he?
And this is the matchup. If you've seen, they're relying all on Nalin's play. So we'll need Nalin to hang in there. But no, this is a big play. If he's going to fizz it in as he comes in and bowls again. That's an off stump. He smoked it over cover. One bounce four. That's a great shot. Nipico really needs to focus in and guide the team through here. And a bit of whiff, though, but that's a beautiful cricket shot over cover. We got to see the replay. That was a great effort.
And Shana really liked the starty by the Fear of Sharks.
We'll share microphones here, Damo, as a technical problem. But it's good stuff on Williamson. That was just probably a little bit overpitched. And as he comes in the bowl, third ball. Over our soft stump again. He's gone through a cover. That's four more. Too much width. He's got to target those stumps. Well, why not go for four? Yes, it's gone. Godfrey's wasn't quick enough. He's got to bowl a little bit tight. But that's good batting. That's good shooting. Slightly overpitched, but not bad bowling.
Well,
great shot.
I hope we get a replay. Aren't the guys good with their hands, also good with their feet? Philip there gets a foot to it, but still doesn't stop the boundary, though. Here we are on the replay.
They're just too wide. He's just got to get into those stumps like the first ball he bowled. Slippers out now. So not the best stuff when we've seen this. Missed the first few games. Looks a bit rusty. He comes in the bowl to Nalin Nipico. That's a better line. Is it mid-wicket?
And that should go all the way to the boundary, Shane.
No, oh, Patrick Montezuma's there. Pick up and throw.
Great,
there's
a
run out
up.
On. Could be Nipico. He's made it home.
No doubt. That's really good running by Nipico on the end. A bit of a mix-up, and he's made it all the way back.
Yeah, poor running for Mappo. Was just running for himself. He can't run out the cap. That's a good ball. And then quick at the stumps. You don't take two to Patrick Montezuma.
We don't take two and get away with it very often.
Pick up, throw from the boundary. It's a powerful throw from the boundary. And Apo's just run and nearly sacrificed his captain, probably best player, well, by far their best bat.
And he's a good throw, direct hit. And he's laughing now. But if I was batting with him, I would not be smiling there.
Here we go. Melissa in again. In the Bellevue end. Oh, way down leg side. And Narling Nipico won't be happy. He's missed a boundary opportunity there. He would have loved to put that one away. I like this start here by the Afira Sharks. Here we go, Nalissa in again. A little bit wide, he's given it a full length, he's hit it over point. Did he get a hand to that? But it's gone away to the boundary for another four runs there. And Narling Nipico gets the width that he wants, and he puts it away. And Wett takes us through to 20 off 1.5 overs. Nalissa coming in again, wide again, and stays a little bit low, a little bit flat, a little bit low, and Narling Nipico just plays over the top of that, and that takes us to the end of the second over, and we are none for 20 off two, and that's a good start by the Afira Sharks.
Yes, mate, sorry, fix the jumpy castles, got a few hats on today.
We're multi-talented.
The CEO's going to do it all. Just upset about 20 kids and turn off the jumpy castle. There's a bit of a hole in it. Unfortunately for them, but good start. And Nipico leading the way. Good over from him. Struggled a bit there, Nalissa.
Yeah, Nalissa just struggled with his lines, didn't he? He was outside off. He was outside leg. We've got Andrew Bensali coming to the bowler, captain now. We do have the Banana Bay Doctor starting to pick up. So if behind the bowler's arm, right to left, there is quite a bit of breeze coming right to left. Build a partnership. He drags it leg side and it goes straight to Patrick Mataltava, and he will not drop them, and Apolini Stevens' experiment has failed.
Yeah, not sure. Well, they're just trying to get something out of him, I think, because he can hit a big ball. Maybe it's a pinch hit to try to get some. Well, it was sort of in the slot to hit, but he's,
I think it was definitely in the slot. He just lost his shape and pulled it leg side. If he hit it straighter, I think it was the shot. And that is not a Bet Bada Vanuatu blast shot. We've got Beth and Molly coming in at first drop here. And I hope he takes off where he left the first game this morning.
He's an impressive young man, Damo. He's going to figure in the national team sooner rather than later. Yeah, he'll be a 10-year player plus over the next few years. So, big, him to get into this tournament now and play a major role, hopefully win his team a game or two, it's going to stand him in good stead to be a experienced player moving forward.
So, outgoing Vanuatu captain Andrew Mensali in, Beth and Molly comes down,
oh,
and
he's
straight down
the ball.
Straight not, down the water. Throat.
Well, that's not his game plan. He just called the Banana Bay Doctor, he's just picked up a little bit. And he's a guy who works the ball, hits the gaps, and he's trying to hit the big six over wide long on first ball. He hasn't got the big back lift that he needs to be able to hit that power, and he's not going to be able to hit it if you don't get right in the middle.
He's probably hit it 60 metres into the wind there, and he either had to just check his shot, go straight down the ground, and he's devastated the young fella. He knows he's made a mistake there.
Oh, I'm not sure. Mate, you must be pulling what hair you've got left, which is not a lot, a bit more than me.
Yeah. Look, we've got Narling Nipico out there. He scored 17 of 20 runs. The game plan is simple. You support Narling Nipico while he's at the crease. He must face as many balls as possible.
You can understand Apo trying to hit it. That's his go-to. Use him as a pinch hitter. But, yeah, Beth and Molly had to get one as they cross. So Narling Nipico's in. He's gone big. That's six. That's out of there. All Beth and Molly have to do is get bat on ball, get him on strike.
He does, yeah.
When he's hitting them this hard, he's a bit like the other boys. You can't bowl if he keeps hitting the middle of bat.
Well, he hit 20 off the first over in the first game. Now he's hitting boundary six. He's just hit over the Vanuatu Beverage sign down the ground. And that's another great six, an ominous sign. See, if he can bat 30 to 40 balls, this will be a good score.
That was a Bet Bada blast, that shot. I'll give it a strong tip. He blasted that out there, as Tony Gregg would say. As Andrew Mann says it again. It's tossed up again. Oh, he's punched it just for one. Oh, the field and knee fell over. It was a bit quicker, that one. He pushed it through a bit on him, and
Good bowling, good batting. Yeah, I think it was very well done by both there.
I know Simon Keane, the coach, has talked to the spinners about practicing their Yorkers a bit more when they're under the pump. So maybe he's tried that then, because that was a bit fuller and faster. And that's a good defensive bowling tactic.
Yep, and Sampson get his second chance today here. Just hope he knows his role, supporting Gnarly Nipico as he man Sali comes in. And
bowl first ball again. Seriously, Dono, what are your Sharks doing out there?
They just need to understand what their job is out there. There was no need. He's gone 6-1.
Get him on strike. What a good shot is this? Cross line sweep, top of off stump. Good bowling.
Very good bowling. And they are 3 for 27 up to 2.5, and the Sharks are in trouble again here.
And Sampson's missed the first few weeks and has come out and got two first ballers.
Wow.
Thanks for coming, Sambo. Now, Jamal's got to step up here and hit smart. You've got to give Nalan a chance to get 60 by batting with him a bit longer. And yeah. We're just not doing it. I'm at a loss, mate.
Well, at our very first trial, this was the partnership that actually set up one of the greatest innings ever. So, look, Jamal, he'd be a little bit disappointed with his first innings dismissal. I think he'll know his role here. He's a very smart cricketer, so he just needs to get in there, support Gnarly Nipico. One delivery to go here from Mansali.
He's not good. He doesn't like the spin early. He comes in, punches it down the ground for a good single. That's what the others should have been trying to do. Sampson and Bethamoli, wild swings, and really cost the team a lot there. And it's down to these two because there's not much to come after that.
Well, and Mansali's taken 3 for 8 off his first over. It takes him through to 3 for 28 off 3 overs. Their run rate's good. They just need a partnership.
I'm not sure what the game plan is for here with these guys. So it's very disappointing. From you, be disappointed in the Palmer Sharks fan. Have we got big Darren Wartu ready to come in from the Bet Bar to Bellevue Hill end? Big fella, can get it up to 130s on his day. He's big, strong lad. Hit the winning runs last week, which I used to have the old French cricket backlift, but obviously working with Simon Keane, that was a beautiful backlift and swing for 6, and that was a great result for him. And now he's got ball in hand, and he needs to produce something for his team. If he can nick one of these boys out here, it's going to be a tough afternoon for the Sharks.
Just outside the power play here, so what are we coming in from the Bet Barter Bellevue Hill end with this field spread? We've got a third man, we've got mid on, deep square, and a fine leg. An interesting field again. Jamal won't mind this. If he gets a straight ball outside off, he'll be looking to put it through covers where there's open spaces behind that.
There's no sweeper on the offside, Damo. I'd have one out there. He's chipped it back to the bowl, and that's out. Trying to hit two square again there. I'd like to see the line of the ball. It's leading edge again. He's got to get a bit more face to the bat as he falls over. It's on outside off stump, and he's trying to hit it at the square leg.
Well, I think his intent is just to rotate the strike, isn't he? Just gets it all wrong.
Yeah, you've got to hit straight down the line. The Sharks, poor batting woes continue. I don't know what the answer is going to be. Nolan's there by himself, but I think Apo Stephen, Betha Molly, and Samson Kalawai got to really take a lot of responsibility for this. That opportunity is there, and they've swung madly across the line, got out. We're the best, one of the best players, the captain of the national team's there, who looks in ominous form. He can't get on strike.
Yeah, well, he can't get on strike. Well, we've got William Yamak coming out, good clubman. He's down the order a little bit from this game. Look, he'll like the pace on the ball here. He will hit it straight. If the space is still open near cover there, that will be his go-to zone. He won't mind this. He's faced spin and got out. This will be opportunity getting some pace bowling.
Yeah, and it's good pace too from Darren Wartu, so he'll be keen to get into it and get another wicket here. Wicket off the first ball. As Darren Wartu comes in the bowl. Yeah, mate. Oh, it's stayed a little bit low.
It stayed very low, and it's gone straight through to the keeper. Watto going back to his mark there. That was an interesting ball. It
full-length ball and just stayed very low. There is a wet spot in the pitch there, I think.
Oh, no, as he comes in, something's got Yamak needs to get bat on ball here and get another Nipigo on strike. It's 40. Oh, it's just a little bit of away swing, a little bit of maybe off the seam. It's played inside the line, nearly nicked to the keeper. Good bowling from the big fella.
Yeah, I think William Narak just needs to relax here a little bit, just wait for that ball to come to him.
They're in a hole here, 28 for 4. Nipigo's on 24.
Oh, he scored just about all their runs here. That's secret. Get him on strike while he's going well.
He can't score if he's not on strike. It's a good ball from big Daz Watu.
Dan Watu, he's gone wicket, dot, dot, dot. So it's a great over so far from Watu.
Well, they've got to regroup a little bit, I guess, because it's been appalling batting from the Sharks boys here.
And I just see the manager of Fear of Sharks just talking to his players. It's obviously due to come in next there. He's obviously got some clear instructions. And while Narling Nipico's out there, 100's not out of range here for the boys. Watu in. And Yamak tries a big shot over cover and he's missed that.
Yeah, he was late on that. Yeah, really behind the eight ball here, the Sharks. It's a lot to do, but the pitch might get a little bit worse in the afternoon. But I'll tell you what the Bulls are. They're a front range. If they can get in front early, they will dominate. That's what they've traditionally done in club cricket in the past. They're good front runners. You give them a sniff, they won't let you back in the game. As big Darren Waters in the bowler, William Yamak, outside off stump. He's pushed it to the offside. No run there. That's his favourite shot, the cover drive.
And that is a wicket maiden, Shane.
Wicket maiden in T10 cricket. Well, you got one bloke on 24 out of 28 runs and you can't get him on strike. It's pretty average play there from the Sharks. They've got to look at themselves, apply themselves a bit better, and have some game plans of what their job is as they get on the field. At least Nipi goes on strike now to Andrew. I think he must be so frustrated, he's just going to swing.
Well, I think he just needs to.
They've got to get 100, so he has to. Spinners on, he's got to try to take him down somewhat, I think.
Yeah, well, pick your bowlers. I'm not sure. I don't think he's got a preference to spin or to pace bowling. He'll have a go at anything if it's a bad ball. And that Banana Bay Doctor's dropped off here, so don't worry about the shots at mid-wicket or down the ground. But when you hit him 90 metres, it doesn't matter with the wind.
Looks like he's got a good classic bat there. So he's Andrew Mansali in the bowl. Nipico. He's gone leg side. He's hit it flat. He's got in the gap. That's 4.
And that's a couple of bounces into the square leg there. And that is 4. And that's a great start from Nipico in this over, who's moved to 28 out of the 32 runs of the Afira Sharks this afternoon's game.
Mate, he must be extremely annoyed with his teammates there. And Andrew's going to get the field right. What have they got? They've got 1, 2. Okay, they've changed the field a little bit. Not sure what he's doing in the field. He's actually opened up. Deep mid-wicket is open up now.
And where he probably likes to hit him when he does that late flick with the wrist. So he hits him just on square and the fine leg's gone, fine leg. Here we go, Mansali in. He's hit it straight down the ground.
He's got it all.
And he's got it all and then some. And that's 20 metres back. And that is another great 6.
Yeah, they've got to score 100 with the Mille Taffia Bulls lineup. They've got to score 100. So he can't just try to score 80 and bat the overs out. He's got to go. And that was tossed up in the slot, and he hit it straight down.
Well, Mellie Taffia Bulls, they chased down 130 with one ball to go last Saturday's game, an epic second game last week.
Sensational game.
So we need at least 100 here from the official.
We need 100, mate. We need 100, and Nipigo's going to have to score 90 of them by the look of it.
Well, he's moved to 34 off 38.
He might have to get 100 of them.
Mansali in.
So he's gone again, and that's in the gap.
Flatter,
that's 4.
And it should be 4 down the ground. He's hit just under the Bet Barter sign there next to the side screen, or what's left of the side screen. And he goes 4, 6, 4. And I hope the guys are watching. They really need to support Nipigo here.
He's got fast hands. I know people around the world are watching this. He has got serious fast hands. He can hit a big ball. He's gone again. He's hit straight to Montatava. One bounce. Oh, he's got a bad bounce. And Montatava just put the old left mid out and stopped it going for a certain 4.
He's a very good fielder, but he was a little bit casual there, wasn't he? He was nearly beaten by the spinny bounce.
Yeah, the odd crab hole has popped up over time at the VCG, and I reckon that's hit one. As he comes in the ball with Yamak, he's chipped it back to him and got out. There's just no intent in what they're hitting the balls or hitting the gaps or what they want to do.
Well, I think William,
he's got the right idea.
Willie just wanted to turn
it. It's lazy. It's just put the bat down. Here we go. Boom. What? That's under tens cricket. He's better than that. He's got to get a bit more intent. Get his head into the ball, push in the gap, a bit more intent, run hard, have some meaning. He's just like he's... I don't know what he's doing there, mate.
Really good clubman, William Yamak, but not on today. We'll get the Vanuatu Bet Blast this afternoon. Mansali coming in for the last delivery in the fifth over.
Mansali in the bowl. It's one single. But that might keep Nibiko off strike, and it does. I wouldn't have taken that single if I was Nibiko. I would have been standing firmly in my crease.
And we're 5 for 44 after five overs.
1-2, 1-2, am I? Are they me or no?
We had a little microphone glitch there. I think Damo took it to karaoke last night and it ran out of batteries. I'm not too sure. What was the karaoke song last night at the...
I have no go-to song there. I do have Watu coming in from the Bet Barter Bellevue Hill end here. And we've got Nipiko at the non-strikers end.
Yeah, and he's got a single... Nico Udavalo got a single off the last ball.
Well, it was a good over. It was 16 off the over with the one wicket there of William Yamak. Look, I hope Nico Udavalo has thought a bit from his first innings just before. It could only be 30 or 40 minutes ago. He's back out there now. He really needs to support Nipiko here.
I would have bought a spinner on for him as Watu comes in.
And that ball's kept low again there too. What's his plan here, Shane? He's got he's going to bowl full. He's got a third man, a fine leg up, and he's got mid wicket, mid on, mid off. So he's just going to bowl full and attack the stumps.
He normally just bowls that top of off length, and there's no point. So anything through the offside is four. So I'd be giving him some protection on the offside if I was the captain. And there it is. There's four runs.
And you called it, Shane. That was a great shot.
It's a bit
Nico.
Of pace. That was lightning. That's Philip, I think.
Of course, it's Philip. Andrew Mansali backing up there, and he comes back for two. But a nice shot by Nico.
Yeah, no, he needs to have some protection on the offside. He's got a square leg in the ring and a square leg on the fence. So they're standing nearly in front of each other. As you might see on your screen, one on the right and one on the left of the umpire.
And a fine leg as well.
So I'm not sure that's the field placing that's required.
And the six over here. Watu comes in from the Bet Barter Bellevue Hill end. It's on the stumps. He's cracked it just a point. And that's good fielding. And he's got the throw in off balance. And they've got through for a single. And we've got the man on strike, which we want. Here's the Vanuatu Bet Barter Blast player of the moment. He's 39 of 46 runs out of the team total.
And he's hitting them brilliantly. Everyone put the mock on him, which I've done the most players. I've done the Patrick Mototava every innings.
I think just good cricket shots here is what we need from in these middle couple overs. Just build it and really explode in the last couple overs.
Mid on has come up.
Strange.
I don't know what's happening in this field place. It's a bit all over the shop here.
And takes the pace off. He guides it behind gully, or through gully, just a third man there, and he gets a single.
We've got a backward square leg and a deep square leg. I don't think the captain or the bowler is quite aware... They've got two fielders standing in front of each other. And there's William Singh. Now, listen, that fielding position. He keeps waving at the bowler to say, oh, I'm here. Do you want me here?
Yeah, where do you want me?
He's in no man's land. You're probably going to catch now, I said that.
Interesting. The man on fire, the mid-on is coming up to the 30. When the non-striker's there, he goes back to the fence. Here's Watu in. And Nico just pushes it forward to short cover there where Mansali fields it. What I'm trying to say was Nico Udavalo comes to strike. Mid-on goes back to the boundary. The man on fire, the Vanuatu Blast, Bet Barter, Big Bash player.
What's a competition called, mate?
Gnarling is on strike. The man comes up to the 30-metre circle. I don't get it.
Yeah, no, you're right. As Darren Waltu comes into the ball and the Bet Bada Vanuatu blast. And Nico's gone over cover.
Nico goes over cover. We want him to go. And has it gone all the way? And it looks like it has.
All the way straight over the Bet Bada sign out there. An extra cover. And they had no cover out there. It was a strange field. They had William Signalesa sitting here at square leg waving, going, I'm not supposed to be here. Yeah. But what's this pressure over cover six? That's whiff. It's a wide ball with no deep point.
It's exactly what Nico needs, so he can just let those big arms go. And he's helped Narling here. He takes the pressure off Narling by hitting off the six off the last ball, 10 off the over, takes us through to 5 for 54 off six overs.
How you going there, Dave?
Oh,
what's happening with yours?
Need some water.
You have a drink, mate.
I'll have some Vanuatu.
We've called the Vanuatu Big Bash Bit Batter Blast at one stage, yeah?
I'm excited that we haven't lost a wicket in that over.
Classic, mate, classic. Having a bit of fun here, guys. We've got Godfrey coming in the bowl now, so he's into the squad bowls.
Let's talk about the batsman. This is who Narling Nipiko would need to target out of the bowlers.
If he goes too square on the leg side, I know the Banana Bay doctor's just settled a bit, might hit straight up in the air if he goes across the line too much, but there's a huge gap. I reckon if he goes straight, mid-on's really wide. I reckon if he hits dead straight towards the camera, that's a big gap, or over cover if he gets that chance.
Coming in, it's full ball.
Is it straight? They could get two here.
No, they just block it down there, and he just pretty much walks through the last 5 metres, and that's a single. And Nico won't mind this with a little bit of pace on the ball here as well.
I think the leggy's got to come back on over bowl soon.
Yeah, Nelissa, I would imagine he'll bowl next. Here we go, Godfrey. The keeper, and it's gone down for four byes.
Godfrey's giving the big double teapot there. The bowler doesn't like the keeper missing them. I don't mind the keeper up to the stumps, but probably not to.
Third man's come back and mid wickets come into the third.
I think they had five out. They had only three inside the circle there. The umpires have missed one there. That's a great takedown leg side.
Great takedown leg side. We do have to be coming in again. Nico, drags at the leg side. And they get a single there. Takes us 11 off the over.
It's a good over. They needed that.
And that takes us through to 60. I've got us at 65. Shane, I can look the scoring here. We've got it at 64,
I think.
After seven. And this is what we missed in the first innings, that middle partnership.
Yeah, well, they batted like clowns.
They did bat like clowns.
Yep. You don't need big shoes and a red nose to be a clown. Yep. I'll give you a tip.
And Nico's, he's been hogging the strike a little bit. And Narling Nipiko is at the non-strikers again. We have Patrick Matautava coming on the bowl. So Nelissa would probably be bowling the next over.
And Sally's bowled how many there, Damo? He's bowled two.
Watu's bowled two. This will be Patrick's second. We got one from God pushing or calling for that. He goes back. Who are they bringing into the circle?
Yep. Fine leg is coming up. You called it. He's going to look.
Well, he's going to go full in at the stumps, isn't he? This is the wicket he wants.
I reckon he's going bouncer or slow ball bouncer here, mate. I reckon if he goes full, he might.
Okay, I'm calling full in stumps.
Okay.
Batsman's gone back into his crease here.
No ball, it's a no ball, surely. It's a no ball, it's over the waist. It's a no ball. It's been called, it's over the waist height.
Square legs called that no ball.
It was over the, I called it from here. I think it was too. He should have hit that out of the ground.
Yeah, well, surprised me a little bit, the full ball, didn't it? But it's got a free hit to Nico and Valu here. And Narling Nipiko to get back on strike, wasn't it?
Yes, I would have been very happy if he just put the hand up and taken the dot ball.
I'd imagine it's going to be Yorker, so let's see if he goes over cover.
Bouncer, good ball.
That's a good bouncer.
Bowled the bouncer well on this deck to get that through. That pace is pretty good bowling.
And that's a great way to bowl a free hit, no ball.
It is.
Did they have too many outside the circle, or did they just change
no,
this?
No, it was, that was a...
Change the no. They've put he's a specialist French cutter, so they've put fine leg back, Shane.
Well, you have to. That's been his best shot today. He's hit one over cover as he comes in again. He's short ball again, and that's good bowling. That's good pace. 130s, easy in the mid 130s, getting that through to Clement Tommy.
And Nico here, he's known to hit a few flat bat shots here, so I don't think he can go three in a row like that. This one have to be pitched up.
I think that's a good length. I'd be sticking to that length if I could.
If he bowls that length again, it's going over the grandstand, Shane. Okay. Here we go. Matt Altava comes in. Full ball, and that's going to go...
Mid-on's under it.
Mid-on.
Young fella, and he's grabbed it.
And that's a nice
catch there.
I think it was in Nico's zone, so I'm not going to blame him for getting out there.
No,
did he just roll the fingers on that, Shane?
A little bit.
As we watch the replay, goes down there. Didn't have the Banana Bay win behind him, and that's a nice... ice cream cone catch there.
Yeah, by Godfrey. He hit a little ice cream cone, was it?
Little bit there. And Matt Altava takes a wicket.
Well, that's good. Look,
hasn't found the strike.
They should have stopped in there.
Well, yeah,
Was it? Call it straight away. Let the player know. And as we. And Ruckle, as but the main thing is that Nibby goes on stride to Patrick Matutava. The two big guns head to head. Tava bowls. He just plucked the offside, take the little single.
And he's going to keep the strike, which is exactly what
we
want.
There's a few more balls. There's a no ball there. You missed that one.
Oh, okay. We have missed that one.
A couple of balls left. We're only Bon Jovi halfway there, mate. Got to kick him away for a single, do something.
It's at the stumps as well.
There's a stumping chance, and he's missed it. Must be wide.
No, it went between his legs. The keeper's hit the stumps there. It's not a chance at all. Clement Tommy out of the Peter Duffy's table has made a meal of it.
That was a tough chance. Non-keepers think he's made a meal of it. That was a tough chance. I'd like to see the replay of that one, but it was a tough take.
And we have Matt Altava just resting at short, fine leg there. You don't see this every day.
Well, he's gone in. He's pushing John O'Dunn for the specialist 45 position.
There we are, Godfrey coming in from the Lagoon End.
Nice shot, that.
Nice shot.
That was a great straight bat. Yeah, the Damien Smith straight bat.
Well, he could have batted three or four higher today with that shot amongst some of these other guys.
If Fernando gets another game in front of him, the big questions should be asked.
Shane, this is the matchup I want to see. I would like to see Gnarling face last four balls. Regardless if he hits a single, I want him to stay on strike. Here we go.
He's got to hit straight. He's gone the scoop. And it was a slow ball. It's really well bowled. It was the slow ball I've ever seen. What did you see?
Did he go too early? And maybe Godfrey, who's bowled him on pace. He hasn't bowled too many off-pace balls. And I don't know why, but you're going to scoop it towards your best fielder that's hiding at short.
But he's really square there. There was a big gap there. Oh, it's quite square at 45. He's more...
He didn't have the pace to work with. Godfrey in again, Lagoon End. It's on the stumps, hit the pad, but that's...
He's got to go for a run. There's a run out, non-striker's end. He's giving him out. Ooh,
is he giving him out?
That was going down the leg. Yeah, he has. I'd like to see that replay. Last replay. A little bit annoyed if I was a batter on that one, but anyway.
Well, Nigel Morrison. I was excited because they'd crossed, but not...
Not LBW.
LBW. Really
Stephen Sandy, he played one of the trio. He played an appalling shot last game.
One strike, yeah. We're 8.4 overs, we've gone. Second last over and we've gone. .11 wicket.
Yes, we just saw some footage of the Holiday Inn Hospitality tent. It is chock-a-block there today.
Well, it's got everything there. It's got beanbags, it's got jumping castles. It's got good hot food. I can smell it from here. Godfrey coming in. Lagoon End. What's Stephen Sandy got? He's got the inside edge of Matt Altava. He's going to run out.
There's going to be an overthrow here if they want it. No, he's overrun. He's only got one ball to face now.
And Nipico wanted the strike, didn't it? So he was going. It didn't matter what happened to the other end there.
I think get yourself on strike, hit with the Banana Bay Doctor. You can get 20 off the last serving. That's the team to 100. If he swings mad and gets himself out of here, I reckon he just push a single. Scoot. He's gone big, isn't he? Six, well, just hit a six.
Yeah, if you can do it, hit a six.
That's 50. He's hit. That's a big hit, too.
Yeah. Here we watch the replay again. Now, he faked the ramp. I'm glad he didn't. So he's just gone back.
Bang.
He's hit balls that. At leg side. It wasn't his best shot, and he's still hit at 85 metres.
It's a good shot. Stefan Sandy is really got to get him on strike here. The spinner is on. He will give you something to hit. That's a good 50 by Nalan Dimbicade. Geez, his teammates.
That's a
particularly number one, two, have let him down. Three, yeah, William really. Yamak as well.
Yeah, really let him down. Look, we're 7 for 83 after 9 overs here. Like we say, we just need to get Nipico on strike here and watch him go bang, bang, bang. Look, he just didn't get that strike in the 6th, 7th over when he just didn't get the strike, did he?
Big call bowl on the leg in the last over, hitting with the breeze. Just picked
and he doesn't
up
have a mid-wicket.
No, Zeke, mid-wicket. Geez, Stefan said he might have to take it himself here. Nah, he's not a champ. They've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They've got 7.
On the offside.
No, there's 7 in the circle. They want two sweepers. They want to keep him on strike.
Keep him on strike. Well, he's just got to go.
He's got to hit and run.
It's the last over. We got Stefan Senni. Use the force, son. Go big. Even a miss hit will get him a singer. He just got to get it past these fielders here.
Yeah.
He can hit a boundary. This will be flat and fast from the listen, no doubt. He'll be straight at the stumps.
Stefan's no mug with the bat. He's petrified of the quicks. Maybe the spinny is a chance. That's a good ball. They've got to run, and that's a good
ball. Misfield by Philip there. And this is what we want to see. Four balls left. Nipico on strike. Hope he does not move. I hope he just bangs him downtown. And then going to actually blast for the next 4 deliveries and gets a shrew to 100 runs.
Well, Damo, you've been on fire today, I tell you. We've got long off, long on, deep mid-wicket. Deep
doesn't
square,
matter. He's going to swing that hard, mate. It won't matter where they're fielding.
Extra cover. I'll cover point.
Melissa in. He's bowled it short.
That's,
and that's
out
six.
Of there. Well, that gets the spare ball. Don't make sure you get that ball, young fellas. That's $80 out of the Vanuatu Cricket Association kitty. We want to get that ball back, please.
Yeah, here we go. Watch the replay here. Melissa just rips it flat and straight at the stumps. A bit short, actually.
Bit short. Didn't get up, but that's great shooting by Nalan Nipico.
And that takes him through to 60.
Like it teams, franchises around the world, you've got to be looking at Nalan. He bowls 130s with the ball. If he's on his day, he can hit him anywhere.
And
he's proved today he's got the scoop. He's
and when, all what we haven't seen is when he swings the ball. He can swing them both ways. He swings them a long way. Here we go. Melissa in, pressure's on. Doesn't matter where these fielders are. Melissa in, pitches it up.
Oh,
and he goes straight down.
Straight over mid off for 6. Bowling the spinner in the last over. What do you reckon, Damo?
Look, I think they were going for the wicket. Here we go. Melissa coming in on the replay. Gets it outside off stump. Gives him some room. Boom. Bang.
He looks short of a gallop, Nalissa. He hasn't bowled in the last 4 weeks.
Well, has Nalan Nipico just overtaken Wesley Vira as the Bet Bada Big Bash player?
it's Big Bash from it's the
big,
blast.
Big
mate.
Bopper. That's a big bopper.
A big bopper. There's only one big bopper. That's Wesley Vira.
Here we go. Pressure's on Nalissa. What's Nalissa got to do for these last 2 deliveries?
Not bowl a wide half volley or a half tracker.
Well, he's bowled flat and fast. He's going to rip it again.
That's good bowling.
That's 6 again.
That is
bigger.
Out of there. That has gone. The cameras can't get that. That's in the banana trees.
Is that 30
over
meters?
The archery.
Is that 30 meters over the boundary? That's going to be hitting 90 meters.
That's well over 100 meters. That full swing. That's straight out of the screws.
And the music's pumping, and so it should be.
I'll tell you what.
Gnarling has just gone bang. 6-6-6.
And what is he? Is the bet bottle?
Big
is
bopper. Is the bet bottle big bopper?
Is the bet
bottle blast bet at the moment?
Blast big bopper. Big and bash.
And he's got us to 100. Let's see if he can get us another 6 and get us up to 108.
Mate, that's some serious shooting there. Last ball.
If six. I think a single will take him to equal top score in the tournament.
I don't think he's looking to push a single.
No, he won't be going for a single. A miss hitting a single, he gets the top score. I think he's going six. For,
he's going again.
We're going Alyssa in. Short again, and that's good enough. He didn't hit it that well, but it's six.
Of course he has. That classic bat's another one. Sit the bat fence on the full.
It's over the bet barter sign down there at mid-on, and that takes him through to 108 off 10 overs.
It didn't the Sharks. Their batting revolves around one man at the moment, and the rest of them have got to pull their heads in and get him on strike.
Get him on strike and so really support him.
Nico Unavalu had a little bit of partnership in the middle. Helped him out a bit because he hit a couple of fours. Saving the league into the last over hit the breeze was always going to be dangerous. That's
great hit by Nipico to hit that ball from out near the crease line all the way down there of the bet barter sign for six.
So what the Sharks have got to do now, they've got to take this momentum onto the field and they've got to come hard. They've got to come in like they're going to win this game and come hard at them because the big gun Paddy will open and obviously Patrick Mototava's been gun all around her for a long time. Nalan Nipico's been chipping at his heels to be the big dog of Vanuatu cricket. He's the captain now. He's just played that innings.
Well, a little dog just put 78 not out on the scoreboard, hasn't he? And his last five shots are six. He's gone six. He's off strike. Goes six, 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 six.
Told you. Franchises around the world. You've got to be looking at that guy. He is a bargain because I can tell you. Those balls were well over 100 metres here. Yeah. Those ones out the banana trees.
Without the pace of the ball. Hey, this Gabba pitch.
Unbelievable strikes.
This Gabba hybrid pitch is playing beautifully this afternoon on this Vanuatu day.
Yeah, mate. The sun's been shining. The weather's been hot. The music's pumping. I hope you can still hear me. But, the Gabba grass. I don't know what they call it. Gabba sports, the hybrid pitch. I think it's called the... can't think of the exact name of the hybrid pitch, but fantastic. I had a pitch report this morning. They look amazing. It's hard. It's a game changer for Vanuatu cricket. It's a game changer for associates.
Yeah.
I'm sure I'll be on a podcast soon with the emerging cricket guys, and I'll talk through the hybrid, but this is it's a massive game changer.
Yeah.
And he's played. You can hit through the line. You can bowl good spin. Patrick Mototava's bowled good bounces on it. It's something for everyone.
Anyone that's tried to do something, anyone that's tried to do something can do it.
It'll produce good cricket, though, mate. Yeah. Well, it'll produce good cricketers and good cricket players, and that's what we're all about. So,
well, here we are. We're 10 over cricket, and we've had scores of 130, 128, 108.
And 36.
And we've had 36 because it was a little bit wet and it stuck and turned. Stuck and turned sideways. I'm really impressed with this Gabba pitch here. Really impressed with Gnarly Nipico. He's well on his way to the Pacific Private Bank man of the match in this game. Let's see what Patrick Mototava can do in reply.
Yeah. Maybe they'll go to spin early, but they've got Gnarly Nipico at Apo. Maybe he's trying to sneak over the new ball, one of those guys. He's gone spin early. They've gone Obed Yusuf, then they've gone Stefan Sandy, Obed Yusuf, or Vince Vera last time.
Well, we don't have the wind. We don't have the wind factor, I think you're right. Pace on, see if it swings.
Saying that though, Patrick Mototava's got out the spin in the first over every game.
He won't do it four in a row.
I didn't say that. I did not say that. You said that. Yeah. I'm not touching that.
Look, I think last week the mighty Melly Taffia Bulls were woken up. They were under the pump chasing 130. They chased it down 9.5 overs. I think they were woken up in this tournament and look for them to come out this, and they could do it in eight overs.
Yeah, and look, the big guns. Andrew Mansali's got a 70. Patrick's got nothing with the bat.
Yeah. Clement Tommy.
Clement Tommy's got a great 50. Got man of the match last game. So they've got the firepower to chase. They chase 130 easy, but the young blokes chipped in at the end, which none of the other teams have really shown that.
A couple of early wickets is what the Afira Sharks are going to need here on the bet barter. Vanuatu Blast, second game today.
Yes, they do need that. But it's about to kick off. We'll have a little breather for 2 minutes where Damo will catch our breath. Because it's going to be exciting last 10 overs. Of the Bet Barter Vanuatu Blast.
Really looking forward to it.
I need a water. Because 4 hours of talking is getting to me, Dana. You've run out of hair because your Sharks have played ordinary, except for Nala Nipico. So hopefully your Sharks can pull it back for this last game.
Let's see
and you can have
voice.
A celebratory beer for your boys tonight. struggling to get 100.
Well, here we goes, last five shots of sixes, there's 30 runs in the last, in the last seven.
Yep, you do the math. That's pretty good hitting. Yep. They're going with the left arm spin of Obed Yusuf.
Sorry, Shane, I just had a bit of a hiccup there. We've got Patrick Mataltava on strike, Andrew Mansali, non-strikers end captain, Yusuf Obed coming in from the lagoon end.
He got out first over last game. How was that? Wasn't a reverse hit. That was...
The last one was reverse hit. And then previously got out. He just timed the ball too well and got caught on the boundary at mid-wicket.
Against the Sharks, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's a good matchup here. We've got deep mid on, mid-wicket, and we've got a few guys on the circle. Where's short mid-wicket? No,
got
short mid-wicket.
Got slip in there again.
I like this. Here we go. Yusuf Obed coming in. Tosses it up. He comes down the ground. And he's just tapped it 90 metres over to the practice net.
That's huge. That's into the breeze, so he's not having a cider.
And that's how you open in a chase from Patrick Mataltava. And he's missed out three bats in a row. I think he's scored six runs out of three bats with a golden duck, a two-ball duck. And here he goes, opens with a six. And the pressure is on the young 16-year-old.
You'd have to say he's due, wouldn't you? Stewie due.
Very due. And this ground's not big enough for him. Here we go, Yusuf Obed coming in again. Short ball. Pulls it leg side. It's just going to go to the fielder there at mid-wicket. And they just go through for an easy single and brings Mansali on to strike.
Obed Yusuf got Mansali. Caught it slip last time.
A great delivery. Yeah, just stuck in the pitch a little bit, turned away.
It's coming back to me now, that game. So he needs to target the stumps here. Game plan across the line, across the ball.
Yusuf in. Pitches outside. On leg, just goes down leg. He's just tucked it in around a fine leg there and comes through for a single. And these two are super fit and super fast between wickets. So if you want to see some running between wickets, these are the two you want to watch.
Yeah. I did play with these guys only a year or two ago. And it was only running singles. I'll give you the tip. As Obed Yusuf comes in the bowl, Mataltava. It's a bit short. He's hit it off the back foot.
Over cover. And that should roll away. Sammy's chasing hard. He should get that easy, though.
I don't know what he's done there. He's thrown it.
He's gone
30 metres. They're going to be an all run four here. And they've all run four. That's super fast running. And
well, there's the example of running between the wickets. These two very fit guys. Sammy gets the ball a metre inside the boundary, goes to flick it. It's either stuck in his hand, and he's thrown it wide of Apolini
Stevens.
He's
overcomplicated. He just had to pick it up and throw it in. He comes in the bowl again. But it's up. Is that a catch?
He gets a left hand of that at first slip, and that's a lost opportunity there.
He's called it runs.
It was definitely off the bat. Let's get a replay. This is great bowling by young Yusuf here. Unfortunately, the slip wasn't good enough.
Yeah, he probably hit that over cover.
He's so fast at bat speed. It went very fast. Here we go, Yusuf in for the last delivery of the over. Tosses it up again.
And that smart batting.
And Sali
just
pushes it into mid-wicket. Yep. And the bowler chases it himself.
He's knocked it in the mid-wicket there. I would like to see a replay of that one off Patrick Mataltava slip.
And that's here to take 13 off and over. And this is a great way to start a chase.
Well, these two bat eight overs, it will be all over if they're probably about... Nearly six will be all over. But they will give you a chance, and that's what they've got to do.
So we should have Apollini Stephen coming in from the Betbarda Bellevue Hill end here.
Okay, that's interesting.
He's a wicket taker. He's an opening bowler in our national men's team, 50 overs. He is a wicket taker.
Yep, they've been going with spin in the early stages, so they've changed it up a little bit. But say these two are two of the best hitters of the ball in Vanuatu cricket history, and if they stay in for... six overs, they'll be probably nearly all over because they will. Particularly Patrick, he won't be blocking too many. He'll be going after it. And what Apo will do, he will get the melee flick off the pads for six. Is a big play for Apo because he just angles in to the middle leg stump when he gets it right.
I'm not sure if the field's right because he will bowl in swing. And he's got a mid off. Here we go, Apo coming in from the Betbarda Bellevue Hill end, and he just pushes it on the leg and he just. Or it's off the pad, but it'll just go behind short, fine leg for a leg by.
Yeah, you picked it there, Damo. Mid-off's going to be the harder shot with Apo because he hits the length, hits the deck hard.
And brings it back in.
He does, when he goes for four, generally goes over the square leg region, which Patrick's one of the best exponents of the melee flick. And if he flicks it, it'll be going over the grandstand this side.
He's just fixed his feel up here. And I'm just watching up on his run up there. He's got a slight limp, does he, Shane?
He's just putting the West Indian fox in, mate. He loves it.
Here we are, Stevens coming in here to Matt Taltava. This will be interesting. Down the pitch. He hasn't hit it that well, but it's going to be an easy four.
He's gone over cover.
And Matt Taltava has got one thing in mind. He wants to finish this game very, very quickly.
Yeah, so his strength is hard length, top of off stump. So
he's got to hit the pitch.
You generally know where he's going to pitch it, so he's picked a... It's not a bad play for the first ball because he's going to try to go top of off first ball to him. Now he has to bring some defensive bowling skills into the game here.
Yeah, he's got to change up here. It's inside the power play. Matt Taltava coming down the pitch last ball. He's got showing no respect here. What's Apo Stevens going to do now?
And he has
moved it off the pitch, and it's come back and hit him just above the midriff.
Good off-pace ball there.
And that's a great recovery from Apo Stevens.
He's down too. He's got a bit of pain. I don't know why it's always funny, but everyone has a giggle when it happens, except for the person who's been hit. That's a good change-up. Yeah. He had to do something.
Replay here, Shane. Comes in, hits the deck. Rolls the fingers, just comes in, hits him just above the waist there.
We've got
a false start here. We'll come back for the fourth delivery in the second over for the Fira Sharks. Melly Taffia Bulls, second match this afternoon in the Bet Barta Vanuatu Blast.
Which these two will be with these two. You might be right. He's touching that knee there, Big Apo. As he comes in the bowl, steaming in from the Bet Barta Bellevue Hill, and slow ball.
He's dragged the leg side. Samson's out there fielding. He gets the throw in. Oh, a bit of a mix-up.
Throw hit the grass. It just stopped in the grass.
Yeah, it wasn't the strongest arm there by Samson on the boundary. But there was a chance. There was a bit of a stop-start in the second run there.
They are fast sometimes, but you can be too fast.
Never happened to me.
No, I don't know what the feeling's like. Slow ball. Dipped a bit on him. It's not bad.
It's like the baseball change-up, wasn't it? Just really dipped at the end there.
He's bowled two slow balls in a row here, so what's this going to be?
This will be six. Apo Stevens coming in. Outside off. Oh, slower again. Matt Taltava's a little bit frustrated with himself. He just needs to wait on this delivery.
These chips from the Holiday Inn Hospitality Tent are pretty nice, though, mate. If you want to have one, mate, get in there before I scoff them all. But you're doing a great job in the commentary in the meantime.
Another replay here.
off pace. Great slow ball.
Yep. Matt Taltava probably should try to hit it over cover rather than trying to hit it straight. And I've just quickly noticed he's gone 18 off the 21 runs so far. He's majority of the strike here in the first two overs. Apo Stevens coming in again.
Another slow ball. And
very good kick there by Jamal Vera. He's lost it now. They're going to sneak through for baseball style. He's stolen a base, hasn't he?
Stolen a base. And what he has done is stolen the strike.
And I've got a 6, 7, 8? We've got us 21 off two overs. None for 21 off two, Shane. And Narling Nipico coming into the strike here. That's a partnership they need to break if they want to win this game. He didn't bowl the best in the first game.
No.
He's going to need to be thinking about what he wants to do here. It's the last.
Bit of all licorice, all sorts.
Will he have learnt from Apo Stevens? He's just bowled three off-pace deliveries. Four off-pace deliveries. He's gone for dot two, dot one.
Yeah, and the slow ball's been good on this pitch over time. Tony Tomato's got... I think you're right. Apo is limping out there. He's only bowled the one over. He's got to bowl one more over, and he's not 100%. That's for sure. As Nala Nipigo comes into Patrick Mototava. As the ball's short. That's a great shot. Over, cutting off the front shoe.
Well, I'm not sure it was a cutting.
Cutting square drive off
very
the front shoe.
Very fast hands.
Point, and that is a world-class cricket stroke. Not many can play that shot. A bit Jai Surya-like.
Jai Surya. First I remember was Kepler Vessels, wasn't it? That's how old I am.
A bit better than Kepler. That's a fantastic. I wish you see a replay of that. That was unbelievable. He played one of them in a division. I'll go back to that story.
Presses on Nipico here, coming in for the second delivery.
comes in the bowl, Batsatava, pitched up, orthodox straight drive. They're going to pinch one, it's a misfield. They get the one. And we're playing a game in Jersey against Guernsey, and Patrick Mototava off the good quick bowler from Guernsey, bowls good pace. He's flat batted a shot at point. It's hit the old stone wall.
Yeah.
It bounced back across the pitch, back down the hill at Farmers Field, down the other end.
Oh, Farmers Field, beautiful Farmers place Field. In Jersey, yeah.
Short bounce, smacked into the stone wall, rebound, chunk out of the ball, and ricocheted and went across the pitch.
150 metres, 70 one way, 70 the other way.
It was unbelievable. Never seen anything like it as Nala Nipico comes in the bowl again. It's Andrew Mansali.
Off pace.
Wall bowled. No field. Gap on the offside. If you got that through, he's a great exponent of the cover drive. If you've got that through, it would have been four. But evenly poised. I think the Militafia Bulls just edging in front at the moment. A couple of wickets. Good change. You've got Clement Tommy to come in next. Man of the match the last time. Nala Nipico. He hasn't attacked the stumps yet.
Marlon Mansali on strike. Comes in. Slow ball again. He pushes it to cover.
He's hit it. Direct hit will be close. And, he's
and there's a chance of an overthrow. And it will be an overthrow. They just need to relax here, guys.
That's good running.
Very good running.
The actual sweeper got off the fence to the 30-yard circle.
Yep.
But they were through for two.
Yep.
That is sensational running.
Yeah, there was good fielding all around there. It was just too fast running. That's what it was.
Yeah.
And ominous signs here in Mansali. He did the same thing when he got his 75 off 38 the day. He just gave himself a little bit of time to get his eye in. Pressure on the captain, Nipico, here. Two deliveries to go. He's pushed in front of, in the mid-wicket there, and that's an easy single.
It's good pace there by Nala Nipico.
Good pace. I've got one delivery to go, Nala. Yeah, he's going to walk away. He'd had enough. He didn't want to bowl the last delivery.
It's good pace, Nala. Bowling a heavy ball. A good contest this. Last ball of the power play.
I would love a wicket, the Affair of Sharks. And this would be the big wicket. The big wicket. Patrick Mataltavri scored 26 of the 32 runs so far.
Three slow balls from Apo. He got some dots. So I wonder if Nalan will take a leaf out of Apo's book and bowl slow ball.
Why not just go the old-fashioned Yorker?
Hey, Patrick hit him in the head. He might go the bumper for the old square up as he comes in the bowl. That's a great straight drive. For Nan, that's
and
a beautiful
he's hit it
looking
too well, and they
he's
won't
hit it too hard to mid off. That's a beautiful looking shot.
And Apo is quite limping down there, and we've taken 10 off that over. It takes through to 30. It's 31. Look at the score here. We've got 32 on the scoreboard.
And it's got four overs, so that's incorrect. Saying three overs gone. That's right. Isn't it?
Yeah. Three overs gone. Yeah. Yep. None for 32 off three overs.
Yep. So it's. I'd say if this partnership doesn't get broken in the next few overs, they're going to be big favourites.
Well, they're scoring at 10 runs and over, but I don't think that's an issue. They're scoring at 10 runs and over, and they've hardly hit a, not hitting too many good shots, are they? They'll easily go 15 or 20 runs and over these two if they get going. This is the big over from their gun bowler. He needs to do something here. He's bowled a lot of off-pace to Mataltava last over. He's got Mansali on strike here. He looks like he just wants to control the innings and put Mataltava on strike.
Yeah, it's the power these guys possess. It's they've got it up the sleeves. A couple of dot balls. They won't get too flustered by that because I think they can just go big and go bang bang. One, two. Four inside the circle. That's better. There's no deep square. Yes, you needed the deep square.
And these guys on the boundary better be careful. If they blocks it into this 30-meter circle, they'll get an easy two.
I think the leg spinner of Vince Vera, I'd be looking to bring on maybe next. He's a wicket taker.
We're
young
showing
fella.
The off-pace balls are doing something. So yeah. Here we go. Apo Stephen in again.
Use his feet. He's got Nick.
Oh, he's got an outside edge. And Mansali probably gets his first boundary with his worst shot. An outside edge that goes through the Swips, Gully, Corden, down to third man for a boundary. And Apo won't be happy with this. He hasn't executed very well at all. It's nearly over waist tight.
But use your feet. I'm no umpire, but once you use your feet, you used to umpire indoor cricket, and once you use your feet, you couldn't call them.
Fair game, was it? Okay.
That's indoor cricket, though.
Well, now he's bring up mid-off up, and he's put a third man back. I'm not sure if that's right, Apo.
No, I think you set the field for the nick. Mid-off's up. He's hit you over cover before. If you get the slow ball outside off stump, it might go over cover. He's a good shot at shot, and... He's got caught. Oh, he's dropped the
chance.
And they're going for a single.
Oh, that was half chance. That was great work through a little bit injured looking Apo Stevens. Here's the replay. Comes in.
Great slow ball. He's chipped it up.
It was a great effort. It's gone straight back down the pitch. He's taken a big dive to the right. Very good athletic effort there by Apo, and he's limping a little bit more now.
He's still in front a little bit here.
He needs a wicket, so let's go. If you're a Sharks, coming up, Apo Stevens in the bowl. Bellevue end, it's a little bit wide, and he's just punched it out to deep cover for a single. And the fielders are awake now. They're getting that ball in a little bit faster into the keeper.
Yep.
Get the ball in the air.
The Sharks got a bit more of a spring in their step this game. They were a little bit slow out of the blocks this morning with their field. And
well, the captain's led the way with the 78, hasn't he? 78 not out in the first innings.
They've taken this momentum in to of Nalan's innings into this Mele Taffe Bulls innings. As a change of field against mid-off is back. Third man comes up.
He had a bit of success with the off-pace ball here, so let's see what Stephen does this over. We're into Matt Altava. Off
that's
pace,
no
and
ball.
That is out
that's
of...
No
oh,
ball.
He's,
that's
he's,
above the waist, no ball. The umpire hasn't called it yet. He's got to call it. He hasn't called it. Oh, that's a no... Well, I've called that a no ball, but...
I think it was a clear no ball, but that's a wicket they're after. Here we go.
Yes.
It was dropping, but it was well over, and he's just skied the ball to mid-wicket, and it was a nice catch out there.
Samson doesn't drop them.
Samson, nice effort, Samson. And Patrick Mataltava, a little bit disappointed. He felt it was a no ball himself over waist high, but he's on his way.
Well,
and the Afira Sharks are back in it.
I was watching live from square leg. I thought it was a little bit over. There's been a few that they've called them.
It's always difficult, though, calling the balls.
And they're dropping. The slow ball's dropping fast. It's hard, but it's hit the top of the bat. I just wanted to watch Paddy bat a bit longer.
Yeah, this has to be Clement Tommy doesn't coming out here. So Pacific Private Bank man of the match last game.
He was
with his 50.
Had a little bit of a slow start early in that innings, but then he played some great shots, stroked the ball particularly straight. He hit some big sixes.
Really controlled that chase. Yeah, he won't be on strike. He'll be at the non-strikers because they crossed during that.
And that was a big thing of Clint Mackay when he was coaching here. Keep your shape, keep your shape. And when Tommy does that, he looks good.
Very well.
When
balanced,
he goes, yes. When he goes across the line, that's when he gives himself.
Apo
like
is not. Apo gets a wicket. He's not limping as much now. Here he comes in from the Betbarter Bellevue Hill end. Looks a much stronger delivery, and it keeps slow. Is he bowled a no ball?
Slower. He's bowled a no ball.
And Clement Tommy's going to get a free hit.
Well, no, they've only got three. Yes, mid off was outside the circle, I think.
We had our third man back, and
I think mid off was outside the circle. I don't know, but it's a free hit. Love to get off strike. First ball, get a free hit.
Come on,
get
Tommy.
Strike.
That's,
how good is that?
That's the way you start, isn't it? Social cricket rules here. Free hit, first ball.
How good
Clement
is that?
Tommy out of the Peter Duffy stable.
Gale can't get out first ball.
Yeah.
How good is that?
Let's see how far he can hit it with his classic bat.
And
here we are, guys. We're playing cricket in Vanuatu. There's no coronavirus here. That's why we're out playing.
And we're at the Betbarter Vanuatu Blast. And Apo Stevens coming from the Betbarter Bellevue Hill end. I reckon he's going to bowl the change-up again.
Clement Tommy on strike.
Free hit. Yeah, it's well bowled. It could have been wide. It's called wide. I think that's a good call. I think it was just outside there. That was
Shane,
a good
I don't
call.
Think it's a good call. I reckon it's inside the line.
Yeah,
and he's going to give Clement Tommy another chance. Cool. I think it was well bowled by Apo Stevens, if that was what he was aiming to do, bowl.
Well, I disagree. I thought it was outside the line.
Well, let's wait till we get
a replay. The we can't get it right between us two, idiots.
Put some money on this. Put some money on this. And Clement Tommy's going to get another free hit here, Apo Stevens.
Free hit. I thought it was a good call. But you're a bit biased, Damo.
And have they've got too many outside the circle again, Shane?
I don't know. They've
one,
got four,
two,
one, two,
one
four.
On the
bit off up.
Here we are, Stevens.
Bang,
in.
That's six.
And he's teed off where he finished last week with a six with his first legitimate first ball.
That was free hit.
It was a legitimate ball, though.
Oh, yes. Sorry.
Yeah. Here is a replay. Off pace of the back of the hand.
It's in the slot.
Goes down on the knee. Keeps his shape. Hits it quite well. Hits it down and then just in front of the Betbarter stand there over the top of Beth and Molly's head.
He's only bowled slow balls. Maybe that injury. It looks like he's carrying one and stopping him running and hitting the deck hard. Because he's only bowled slow balls. He's not really stimming in as the big Apo normally runs in like a freight train.
I'll take a minute. We'll notice his follow through this time here, because that's probably where you'll see where he's injured or not, is the follow through.
Change of field again.
Mensali on strike.
One, square, deep square out. Yep, Melee flick. Mensali hits the Melee. Oh, it's Tommy, is it? Yeah, of course, hit a six.
Abo Stephen into Bet Barter Bellevue. He'll end full toss. Oh, and he's pulled it square. That's a nice shot. And not bad feeling by Vince Fear there, but they should get back easy for two.
Is that no ball?
Well, if it is, he hasn't called it. And that's a two to finish the over.
Here's
the, replay. Is it dropping again, Shane? Oh,
tough to call. They're line ball. 10, I'll give Nigel Morrison, umpire, the benefit of the doubt.
Well, I got us 1 for 48 off four here, Shane, and the guys are in front of the run rate. I don't think the run rate's an issue here when they're chasing 100, and these guys are still in the middle.
Spin's got to come on now. Spin the win. They've got to try to get a wicket or two.
Vince Vera, I think, should be the go-to man.
I would go Vince Vera. The leggy just is. He is. Looks like Vince Vera's coming on to bowl. No, it's not. Nobody's really sure. Yes, it is Vince Vera.
And Apo, as we said, he must be carrying a little bit of injury. He's gone off there, and a 12th man fielder was just coming out to replace him.
Had to get his two overs out by the look of it. He didn't bowl slow ball, so he must be struggling with injury. He's good in the field too, Apo. So that will cost him a little bit. He's pretty good in the field, Apo.
Yeah.
So great safe hands. The ball goes up. He never drops them.
Big hands, and Jamal Vera helping Narling Nipico here, as most good wicketkeepers do. Just change the field up a little bit here.
There's a big young fella's big chance here.
And he's bowled it full and flat. And we've called it the substitute shield has gone straight between his legs for four runs. And that is not what Vince Vera would want on his first delivery.
No. Ball fella, just, you don't think you're playing, then you get on, and in the hot spot, a deep square leg
to
us.
The first ball comes to you.
To a leg spinner, and it's gone.
Well, it's 10 over game. You cannot afford to be giving away three runs.
Can't. It would have been off strike too. Vince Vera comes in the bowl of Mensali. Outside off stump, chops it down, backward point, no run.
Just, I like the confidence of this guy. He's just tossed it up a little bit outside off there. He's saying, if you're good enough, come and hit me.
He's been impressive with the ball, and he played some good shots with the bat last innings. He comes on the bowl to Andrew Mensali, just knocks it on the leg side for a single.
Yeah, good cricket all round there. I think it was very well bowled. Just hit that middle leg line, drifts into the pads there. He's just tucked it just behind square. The keeper's had to pick that up.
He finishes most games, Andrew, when he's on song. He wins a lot of games for his teams he plays for. He'll be looking to do that again as he comes in the bowl of Clement Tommy. Sweep.
And Clement Tommy probably just not quite happy with his line there. He's just dragged it down to the leg stump it in there again, and just give him a chance to tuck it around the corner for a single.
Clement Tommy swept first ball last game, and I thought it was a good LB shout, so I'll be targeting the LBW for Vince Vera for Clement Tommy as he comes in the bowl of Mensali. Toss it up. It's out to the substitute fielder again, and he's got a leg on it.
He's made a mess for it again. Oh, he's done the same thing. He's cost him another three runs. And that goes across the boundary for four.
It's a tough initiation for the young fella out there, deep square. He's in the hot spot.
I'm calling the shepherd stick. Put him in fine leg, which they are.
He's moving into the John O'Dunn short 45. It's where you usually hide him, and that's where.
A little bit surprised you got two chances out there.
It's tough.
There we go, Mensali on strike here. Last delivery of the over from Vince Vera from the lagoon end.
Short
drags
again.
It down a little bit.
Off the back foot. That's six. So Vince Vera was the we called for the leggy. It was a wrist, but they probably needed to take a wicket. They had to take a wrist. Probably him or Obed, and he's gone for two fours.
16.
And a six. That's a half track, and yep. Mensali.
Mensali just waits on it with that experience.
He has, and he's smacked that over wide long on for six. And fair to say, the Melee Tafia Bulls are in the driving seat now.
Driving seat, and it looks like a fear of Sharks are going to go for two losses today. They need some wickets. One thing the Melee Taffy did is when they got a wicket, they got a couple of wickets together, didn't they? They were really clumped them together.
Yeah. Well, they've got to go bang, bang here.
Well, they need these two out here and put some pressure on the younger guys in the team who stood up last week. Nico Unavalu coming in here. Really like Nico. He got a couple of wickets in his first over last weekend. He just bowled them length balls.
Bowling within himself, he used to steam in off the 30-yard circle and bowl mid-130s, but he's been out of the game for a little while. And he's just off the shorter run, bowling a bit smarter, stump to stump.
big change.
He'll have that effort ball inning where he slips it through a bit quicker than you think. But he needs to have something. He got his wickets caught out this leg side area before, didn't he? Bowen stumped the stump, though, hitting catches out here. Sampson nearly pulled off a cracker. They got three out on the leg side.
Well, he's got to attack the stumps. He's got a fine leg, a deep square, deep mid, wicked deep mid on. Can you have that many out?
Four on the leg side. On the boundary, no one in the circle. And Clement Thomas tried to go big, got back in the box. And probably hit it. Betham munged it the long on for a single. This will be it. The melee flick could be coming out. I've been calling it for a while. Him and Pat are the best exponents of it.
The Bet Barta melee flick. Can we see it come out? Here we go. Nico Nvalu coming in from the Bet Barta Bellevue. He'll end. Mensali comes down. He's just going to push it to short or to cover, and he's just going to take a single there. An easy single there, fielded by the captain. And Nico has just gone for single off the first two deliveries, which is not a bad start.
Yeah, he bowled well in the first game. He stumped the stump. That was a slow ball that time.
Here we go. Nico coming in again. Clement Tommy on strike. Full ball, a little bit of shape. He's just dragged that down. He's just trying a bit too hard there. Betham Molly picks it up there, and he'll go single. So that's three singles off the first three balls here.
It's good bowling. Solid bowling. So they don't need to do too much. Probably need one boundary and over. We'll get him home, nearly.
I really think he's bowled. He's quite like, he needs to bring fine leg up and give him some cover on the other side, doesn't he? Nico in again. Yes. And Mansali's had a great shot down the ground. That's over the Bet Barta sign for six. Or it hits the Bet Barta sign.
That few singles. One had to go. Something had to give there, didn't it? And the old wise Andrew Mansali.
Let's watch the replay. Hey.
Put it
away. Going to score 10 and over, aren't you?
Yeah, you're getting home. He's
Mansali
gone again.
Goes on
it's
the outside. It's high.
Nala Nipiko's underneath it. Yeah, he
and
makes no mistake. Was a cat amongst the pigeons
there.
Yeah,
just got a little bit of wide on it and just got the outside edge. Let's watch the replay.
Wide off stump.
A little bit wide. Yay. And he should have hit it over cover rather than trying to hit it straight. He had to hit through the ball.
Yes, I agree with that. Yeah, as he's walking off, he's practicing going over cover. Just maybe drifted a bit wide on him. Just give credit to the bowler. There was no deep point.
No one out on the offside.
It's a gutsy tactic as we've got William Singh Nalissa coming in the bat.
Well, tell us a little bit, William Singh Nalissa as a batsman. He's known as the leg spin bowler, but he can hit the ball quite
nice
well too.
Nice technique. I remember his first tours of the EAP T20. Was it Fiji or PNG? He hit a six. He went in to face the last ball of the innings and hit a six. He batted eight last year in the 50-over competition. Might have got a 20.
And here we go. Clement Tommy on strike because they crossed. Well, the ball was in the air. Nvalu, I mean, he come down the pitch.
He's bowled him,
and he's gone wicket, and that is. What is that, Shane? That is just some silly cricket. When you've gone nine off the over, you've lost the wicket. You just need to control the back end there. And he's tried to play the big shot.
It's a great celebration. It straightened a little bit. It angled in and did straighten to the top of off stump. But you've just lost. Your captain, your most experienced player, the ball before. Play that shot?
He needed to lead the last four or five overs here.
Well, we've got the young kids from Melee Tavia Bulls coming in again to steer it home. Can they do it 2 weeks in a row?
We're in the oval. When we come back, Nico will be on a hat trick next time we see him.
Not another hat-trick, it's another trophy you've got to buy. I've got two.
No, he's got two. He's got two in a row. He's on a hat-trick,
He's on a hat-trick, yeah. We got two hat-tricks last game or what? Just one. Josh Razu got a hat-trick, didn't he?
And Kenny Tari was on a hat-trick.
Kenny
Tari
was on a hat-trick. All right.
We got Yusuf Obed here. And this will be difficult for the spin bowler coming onto the two new batsmen here. This will be a test.
Stefan Sandy hasn't bowled yet. He's probably...
the better spinner.
One of the best spinners.
He'll have to be at the other end.
He's the up-and-coming spinner of Vanuatu. He's got the dojo, he's got all the tricks. If he bowls from this top end to finish, he might be hard to hit. But he's got to come on the bowl soon. Because they've got...
Well,
Nipiko's got one. Stefan Sandy's got two. Vince Fira's got one.
Well, Stefan said he'll be next, otherwise he doesn't get the opportunity to bowl two overs. Yeah, and this is game on here with the Afira Sharks. They've got a really good bowling lineup here. Let's see if they can close this out. Yeah,
they're just over 10 and over, don't they? It's game back on. It's a big over from Nico Navarro. And Obed Yusuf coming to bowl to William Singh Nalissa. Young spinner versus experienced spinner. That's off stump. Nice cut shot. It finds the field. That's a dot ball.
Dot ball there.
Two new batters. Now we got two new batters.
Two new batters. And that's a great start from the spinner.
Few dots. Could build on there here.
Yusuf coming in again. Lagoon end. Tosses it right up. It's caught. Bolt. Oh, he's dropped it.
It's a chance of a run out. No, it isn't.
Oh, young fella. Yeah, they got a stick, don't they?
Well, I tell you what, you got no one else to blame when you drop the phone ball, at least, haven't you?
Toss that right up. Bottom of the bat. Oh, he got his favourite hand to it.
He's in the bowl again. There's a nick from Philip. We missed the play. They come back for two. Could be a run out. Oh, we just missed that action there. Well, that was a ball. That's off stump. I think it's Philip out there. Went to play.
Oh, it's Philip. Got a nick. I'm going to call him Flying Philip.
Flying
he can
Philip.
Run.
He has got some of the biggest beach muscles I've seen at Melee Beach. I'll give you the strong tip. He's out pumping iron daily. He's quick. He is quick between wickets.
The Bet Bada big bicep player of the day.
He's got the biggest biceps in the Bet Bada Vanuatu Blast, that's for sure.
Yusuf in again. A little bit flatter.
He's gone over. He's that's over. Over.
And that's landed just inside the boundary.
Come into where he left off last Saturday.
Yeah, I think he got a quick fire 21 last week, and he's done the same again. Pulled away, but he's hit it in the right areas.
A little bit slow in the air, I reckon. He's got to fizz it through a bit more. And this slow pitch will stick in the pitch if he fizz it a bit more.
Fizz it through and attack the stumps here. That's what he should be doing. I reckon if he can get in that middle and leg stump here, he'd be a big chance.
We've got three. We've got deep cover point, deep extra cover, and deep mid off. Three on the boundary and the offside.
Oh, and of course, he's nearly snuck it through there. He has it that middle and leg line. He's just got the inside edge, and he's got a dot there. But Philip was going one area, and that was deep mid-wicket.
That six was required from the MT Bulls. They needed something then, didn't they? Obed Yusuf in the bowl again. Flying Philip. Off the wide. I thought it was off the pad. Maybe not. Good wide. MT Bulls. Jamal Vieira's got the double teapot on. He's not happy with that.
The young fella's just failed to finish the over off, hasn't he?
We've got three on the offside on the boundary. He's bowled a leg stump line. Here it is. There's one, two bounces, three bounces, two long on.
Hasn't hit it good enough to get himself out.
So we've got William Singh Nalissa on strike. No, we don't. It's the over.
Nine off the over.
So we've got Nala Nipico. We've got Stefan Sandy. We've got Vince Vieira. And Nico Unavalu will bowl one. Of course.
Yes. Well, will they bowl Nico now?
They're bowling Stefan Nico Sandy. Now. I think Nalan will bowl the last over from that bottom end. He has to. So I'll give Stefan Sandy.
They've got a really good bowling line. They've got a lot of options, don't they?
I'll be giving Stefan Sandy the next from the top end. Make him hit with the spin. The Banana Bay Doctor's not as strong as it has been.
Look, these guys would like the pace on. I think Stefan Sandy, really good spinner. I think the pace off and it tweaked the ball. Bit of bounce too from the quite tall spinner.
Yeah, I think the skipper has got to bowl the last over. From the Bada Bellevue Hill end.
Here we go, Nico.
Nico's ball well.
Navalu coming in here.
We've got five inside the circle now.
So this is a hat-trick ball, Shane. You can call this one.
They've got five inside the circle. Deep points come up. I don't think he's meant to be up in the circle. Hat-trick ball. He stroked it along on for an easy single.
Nice batting by Philip too. He did the same thing in the last weekend's game where the Melly Taffia Bulls had a double header. He was one of their key performance down the order.
And deep points going back now, so he should be. Now this is good through the offside. That's his go-to shot with a cover drive. He's got a lovely technique, more classical technique. No shovels there. He's got a proper technique. Hits him through a straight bat.
Here we go. Unavalu coming in. Bellevue Hill end. Straight ball. He drags it leg side out there to the fielder of Sammy.
That's good bowling. Just tied him up a bit. Couldn't free his arms up. And it's game on. I can't call it either way, Damo, at the moment. It's 50-50. It's a great, another great game of cricket. Associate cricket again.
One really good over is going to change it either way, isn't it? Fear Sharks need a really good over here. Unavalu coming in, full ball, hit it straight. He must field his own delivery.
That's a good mitt on it there. we push them a bit harder between the runs. There's always a chance for a misfield out here. There's a few crab holes and a few bad bounces always in the outfield here.
I like this. Unavalu, he's just going at the stumps. So it's falling at the stumps. If you miss, he's going to hit.
Yep.
He's going to make you play. He's not giving the width.
Tactics, but you know where he's going to bowl. He's got the slower ball. That's not slow.
Oh,
it's
leg
side. Push it down. But if you're going to bowl, if you're targeting that middle leg and jamming the batsman up, you're going to give the odd leg side wide away. And as a captain or a coach, you give them the odd one because they're trying. There's not much margin for error. I'd rather that than a wide pie that goes through third man for four off the edge.
So well, if he just—he needs—he's halfway through this over. He's gone for four. He just needs to finish this over off and give him something to defend in the last two overs. Unavalu in full toss.
Oh,
he's missed that.
That time.
Not called again there either, and that's a dot ball.
Okay.
Unavalu, two deliveries to go. Nalissa's not happy with that. He's not happy. He's missed it.
Well,
not happy with the call.
Let's see the replay. We'll tell the story.
It's just dropping. It's very hard to tell. Drops. I'm happy either way.
Is Nigel defending you in a case this week or something?
Unavalu coming in. Well, we're at the stumps.
They push for two. We've got Flying Phillip. He wants to come back.
Yeah, good feeling. That's the captain.
Flying
Phillip
could have gone. A direct hit would have got him, but Flying Phillip is back. He's got the flying yellow mane at the back of the helmet there too, hasn't he? The old cape. He was Superman last week.
He was. Unavalu, one delivery to go here. If he can just keep this to a single, we're chasing 21 off the last over.
That's good bowling. He's jamming him up in the middle of the leg stump, giving him no room to free his arms. Phillip will go. Phillip can hit the ball early. He can go wide long on here or over cover.
This is game on. This is
last week, didn't he?
This is game on.
And the flying Phillip needs a big six now. That's well bowled.
And it's just in. Oh, I was going to call it just inside the train tracks, but it's been called wide there, and he just failed to finish off the over. We've gone for four singles and two wides. Now he can't afford to. He's got to finish this over off and give him. He's got to give him something to defend in the last two overs.
A couple of wides is costly. Two overs go after this. Oh, it's game on. It's either way.
Unavalu, Bet Bada, Bellevue will end. Full ball, the stumps.
Ah, it's beautiful bowling. Off pace, slow ball, Yorker.
Phillip wants to, but there's no chance. That Beth and Molly, good feeling. Good pace to get in there.
Got off the boundary quick there, Beth and Molly. Flying Phillips got the strike, though.
I'm going to say 89 after 8. And we have 20 to go off two overs.
20 off two.
Who's going to bowl this? Will it be Narling Nipico? He's got his cap off. It's the championship. Over, isn't it? It's the championship over.
Who's going to bowl the last over then?
Well, it's got to be Stefan Senni going to go for the spin last.
We've seen you can't bowl an off spinner
in
the
last
end
over.
From that over. But if the offie goes for 16 from this end now, it's game over. So I guess he's thinking, I've got to.
Come at the man, come at the hour.
But if you're batting, though, there's no pressure. You know you've got six overs of spin at the other end to come.
Six balls of spin at the
six,
other
sorry,
end.
Sorry. Getting excited. Six balls of spin at the end.
Well, this over, he needs to be six or less. You don't want he needs the spinner to have at least 14, maybe 16 to defend at the other end
20.
With that little wind.
You got to say, yeah. And the breeze has just picked up, hasn't it?
It's just picked up. Just as he started to grab this ball here, go back to his mark.
The Banana Bay Doctor's just kicked in, which is on your screens now. It comes from
right to left
over sort of long on to third man. That's the Banana Bay Doctor. If you look at from this end, the lagoon end. That means at the other end, they'll be hitting from your screens right to left with the Banana Bay Doctor.
Oh, what's he going to bowl here? He's got square legs gone back. I'd probably like him to see go full and straight and put a third man back and probably bring square in.
The Nick with the Doctor's going to go for four. He's good over. Oh, it's hard to.
Phillips
on fielders, mate.
Yeah. He just needs one more. Just needs one more.
One more fielder. But yeah, anything. The Nick is on. He hasn't targeted. He's got a ball at stumps here, I reckon. Stump to stump.
That's why I think he needs to have third man going back on the boundary. Here we go, Narling Nipico. The captain, the Afira Sharks, coming in from the lagoon end. Phillip on strike. Full ball, slow ball.
There's the third man.
He scored!
the substitute fielders had two struggling efforts and could have pulled off a match-winning catch.
Well, I think Phillip.
I felt sorry for him out there before. He was under the bump. ball. That's in the hitting zone.
It's a slower ball. He's tried to hit a leg side. The slower ball, he's just got the outside edge. Popped up. Nice little cat. Brandon Myers, he's just let two...
He'd be breathing a sigh of relief after that, wouldn't he?
He's let two balls go between his legs for two boundaries. He's let go of six runs, but he's taken a key wicket there. Key wicket. And he's... I don't know if he's excited or relieved. I think it's more relief.
I think it's relief. Because if he dropped that, I reckon...
Yeah.
He could have just... thrown the hat on the ground, shirt off, walked home.
Yeah, and we've got Nalissa.
Never play cricket again.
They've crossed. We've got Nalissa on strike here. Gnarling Nipico. Come at the arrow. He's scored 78, not out. He's there now. He's got the ball. If he's going to win the game, it's with the ball now.
The nick for four down there. I reckon third man, even though he's got a catch. I bowl full and hard at the stumps.
It's kept very low. Has he rolled the fingers over that as well? But it's kept low, and that's a dot ball. And Nalissa is not sure what to think. He's looking at the pitch. He helped roll the pitch today, so he's got no one else to blame.
Yep.
If we watch the replay here, has he rolled his fingers, Shane? Yeah, yes, he has rolled his fingers. And it's just,
lack of pace, well bowled.
And expect the last few deliveries to be off pace as well. Gnarling Nipico coming in, Lagoon End. Pace on. Oh, and he's failed to misfield it himself.
Vince Fiorita's got to do the work. Ah, it's great bit of fielding at long off. They go back for two.
Chance of a run out.
Good running.
Great running.
They're going for three. They're sleeping. That's super running. They're going for four. Super running.
Great intent by these young fellas from the Melitafia Bulls.
Great running. And the elf, yes. Well, if you lose by one run, you're kicking yourself, aren't you?
Oh, lose by one run, we blame Brennan Myers for losing. no offence, Brennan.
Well, Samson's it. The man of the hour last week with a huge six batting at this end. He hit the first ball out of the ground for
He'll
six.
He'll be very confident.
Can he do
here?
It again?
Was the pace delivery.
He's looking at wide long on you, Damo.
What's Nipico got in his bag of tricks here? It's off pace.
Off pace, well bowled.
It's just keeping low. I think that's probably the trick, the off pace delivery.
It's well bowled. Yeah, he just got through the shot too early. There was a great six he hit last week, first ball out of nowhere. They needed a four to follow up. So he's got the skills. It's up to him to do it again. 2 weeks in a row. It's a lot of pressure, young fella, but it's been a good over. Only three off the over.
Yeah, three off the over. Two deliveries to go for Gnarling Nipico. Lagoon End. With the ball keeping low, it's got to be pace off, I would think, here. Raval Sampson on strike. Pace off, and it is kept low.
Ball again.
Kept very low, and I'd be doing the same delivery again.
Yeah,
maybe a little bit more at the stumps.
He threw the shot early, but you know, you can't quite use your feet there because Nalan's got that effort ball that if he goes upstairs, it's not a bad option now.
Well, his effort ball goes for three with a shot down the ground. Melissa just has a quick chat to me. He probably just said, wait for the ball.
Bring mid off up here and put third man back. I reckon the nick is on for a four here.
Nipico in, off pace again.
Banged
it in. Can Sammy get it?
Gather it in. They're not going for two. Easy on the throw. Sets up a beautiful last. One more ball left. I've got ahead of myself.
I've got us at over.
TV's got it as over as well.
I've got a wicket dot three dot dot wicket.
The scorers are yelling out. He comes in the bowl. Back in the hole. It's a fast York. He's dug it out for a single.
Stephen
Sandy
better
come
in.
They come. It's a one-hand pick.
Yeah, tries. That was his opportunity. Try. Had to go the one hand if he had any chance of
Could
running that out.
No.
He's gone two off the last delivery there.
Well, you called it as a seventh delivery, didn't you?
I did call it a seventh delivery.
TV had it as a seventh as well.
Takes us through to 95. We need 15 off the last over. 14 off the last over, Shane.
14 to win, is it?
14 to win off the last over.
Let's work that out exactly.
Nelson, he's been in the wilderness in the islands for a little while. The three, captain, vice captain, wicketkeeper are together now discussing.
It's got to be Stefan Sandy. He hasn't bowled in this innings.
Sampson has got the ball. He's just faking.
He's faking.
He has to pretend
to give the hat to the umpire. It's got to be Stefan. I wouldn't bowl the young leggy. That's a big pressure for the young leggy to bowl this end. They've got to hurry up, make a decision.
You really want someone to walk over, grab the ball, and say, I want this over.
It's Stefan Sandy. I'll tell you what, if he tosses it up and the Banana Bay's doctor's picked up This
they
is dangerous.
They really need to get this field right, don't they?
This is dangerous. They've got to have the two best catches. They've got two good catches out there.
Really good
Sampson and Bethan Molly out in the hot spot. I'd have another one at mid-wicket on the circle, possibly. I don't think they got a cut shot for four.
Cut shot there. And Sampson took that good catch when the ball was over the boundary. Threw it back in earlier. If they can get that right this time, there's a chance here. Stefan Sandy.
They're taking a long time to get through this. Now they've got... They've got five inside the circle. They could have one more back.
This is really set up for a great last over here.
They've got five inside the circle for my count. They can have a man back. They've got one too many inside the circle.
Haven't quite got this right here.
Well, the
Melly Taffy Bulls got out of trouble last week with a huge last over.
You've got to have players on the boundary. You've got five inside the circle. Could that be costly?
Defending 15 here. Come on, Afira Sharks. Here we go, Stefan Sandy in.
That's stumping.
And that's
nice
stumping.
Good work.
Good bowling. Good wicket keeping
there.
Afira Sharks. And I would have thought Darren Watu would have come in after delivering that huge six.
Watu's coming in for the last two balls. Well, was in the slot. He just got a little bit outside leg stump and he couldn't quite reach it. If he's got a little bit off stump, he'd want to hit that for six. We've got Nonu, I would say, we're coming now. Nonu's a good competitive cricketer. So he's a good beach volleyball player. He's on the Chilea stable. There's thousands of them play cricket. He's got a good eye, but what he is a super competitor with bat and ball. I like Nonu in the field. He always gives 110%.
And watch these guys run. And these guys will run. So if the boundary riders aren't on the ball here, they'll be looking for two.
Once again, they're five inside the circle. They can have one more goes for deep point.
Going back to the 30.
He's only on the 30-yard circle. One, two, three. I'm not going crazy. They've got five inside.
Stefan Sandy coming in from the Bet-Barter Bellevue Hillen. Outside off, and that just goes through for a dot ball.
I tell you, there's no one out on the outside. He's got a
15 off four.
Any bat on that was four runs.
15 off four. This has got to be a boundary, this shot here. Stefan Sandy, this is the key ball.
It's short.
Bethan
Molly's under it. He makes no mistake.
A bit worried. He took a couple of steps back after he caught that ball, but that is a wicket, and that looks like the game over for the Afira Sharks. This is a great comeback. Great comeback with Narling Nipico belting the last five balls. Well, I need 15 or three. Mathematically, if John Laws was bowling, we'd be a chance. And the Afira Sharks have finally come alive today.
Well, you got big, dazzling Darren Watu, is it? It's got to be.
Well, they've
the finisher.
They've crossed. You've got Narling. Nalissa's is crossed to there.
Okay, 4-6-6. 4-6-6, we've got a tie.
No, 4-6-6, we've got a win.
Have we?
Yeah. 109 we're chasing.
So, 4-6-6, how much is that? I can't. I've lost the plot, mate. I'm all over the shop. Yeah, you're right. No. Game on, I reckon.
And I think Narling Nipico is, I'm going to call it a win. Narling Nipico has set up the win with the second last over where he's gone wicket. Potentially had to bowl the extra ball and he's only gone for six off the over.
So I want Watu to finish. I want a three. Then I want a two sixes. That's what I want to see. I want to see big, dazzling
Darren
Watu.
Over. And we'll have a Bet-Barter Vanuatu blast super over.
That's in the dark. We'll be in the dark. We've got 3-6-6 I'm going for.
Bear with us, guys. This will be going to the stands.
Oh, we've got the wrong camera on there. It's a straight to the mid-off for a single. Let's get the right camera on there, Rick.
Well, nothing silly here from the bowler. Make sure there's no balls. Make sure there's no extra deliveries here. The last thing they want to do is give him a free hit.
So, they can't do it. They can't tie, can they?
Well,
2-6s?
Only with a no ball.
Okay, all fielders inside, yep.
Stefan Sandy coming in. Bet-Barter Bellevue Hillen. Toss. Oh, flat, a quicker ball.
I think he stumps. Yes, he stumps.
He's lifted the back leg.
And that's it.
Well, we called Stefan Sandy before. He's one of the leading wicket takers. He's gone wicket dot wicket, one wicket. And it's his first over the afternoon.
Minos Eve. he's just going across.
What has he done here? Has he just lifted the back foot?
That's good pace. Yeah. Firing it into the pitch, really good ball.
And vice-captain Jamal Vera is just
done everything he needed to do, just waited for the ball, takes the bails off, and for the last delivery, we're waiting for the new batsman to come out, which most likely be Godfrey Mangao. This has been a terrific game. Gnarling Nipico has set this game up with the 78 not out in the first innings. He hit the last his last five deliveries for six to get him to 108.
Yeah. And I had Nalis to bowl the last over, which was risky when you got a man like Nipico at the crease.
Crosses. Clement Tommy's on strike. He tries to go down the pitch and he's out to Unavalu. That is the game changer.
I think it's a good call there, Damo. Yeah, he lost two batsmen and two balls. Your two incumbent.
Two key batsmen and your two new batters.
At the crease, and that's where the momentum was slow. And we don't know what we're doing with the camera there, Rick. As well, that was the last ball.
It was
and
flat, it was fast, outside off. He's missed it with a big strike. And we've got 3-1 off the last over. And 7-95 and finishing there. And we'll be back shortly with the Bet Barter and Pacific Private Bank Man of the Match.
Yes, we will be of both games. See you soon.